Hey everyone, how's it going? Wanted to walk you through the new versus returning report, which is actually classified as user type, which you can see right here. Now we're looking again at the demo account in Google Analytics, which you can get for free. Just Google Analytics demo account to see where we're at. I'm also looking at June 16th to July 15th, but we're not really gonna dig into the data today. The point of this report, or the point of this video, is just to like walk you through exactly what it is and get you thinking about what different types of users come to your site. And the most basic one really is new versus returning. So what is a new visitor? A new visitor is essentially just a person who comes to your site on a device that has not been cookied before. That's the simplest explanation. Of course, there are caveats, but that's the simplest explanation. Now, a returning visitor is somebody who has come to your site before on the device that they are currently using and have been cookied before. Really, it's as simple as that. So the first time visitor is a new visitor, and every visit after that, they become a returning visitor. And because Google Analytics is largely based on sessions, it's really simple to get that down. So if you have any questions about that, let me know. But right now, let's just take a look at what this report says. So under audience, under behavior, new versus returning, we're just looking at this data set. And I think that the thing that I'd like to call out is not how to use this report, because I think it's simple. I think that it's really just to look at the different types of users and how they behave differently. So of course you can see a lot of people are new users. That's fairly typical, especially of a site that doesn't have, you know, like a SaaS model or like a reason to come back every single day. If you have a lot of returning customers and you're actually having a lead gen problem, this is likely reversed. People are coming back like crazy because they're logging in, but you're not getting a lot of leads, so there are a lot less new users. So your split will definitely be different than 84 and 16. The other thing to call out is the bounce rate. So new users will typically have a high bounce rate and a lower pages per session. Part of this is because, you know, especially if it's an information site where you're getting a lot of traffic to your blog, people will ask a question, go to your blog, find the answer, and then leave. That counts as a bounce. That counts as one page per session. That counts as 0 seconds average session duration, unless, of course, you have an event or a conversion take place. We'll talk about events and conversions later. So yeah, you'll typically see better metrics on returning visitors, and these are fairly typical. I think the ratio here is right. I think it depends on what kind of site and like the quality of the site. You might have 2 pages per session for new, 3 for returning, something like that. And this bounce rate is actually a little high. I might expect this to be a little bit lower for returning visitors especially. But here too, this is fairly typical that the conversion rate of returning visitors is at least 4, 5, 10 times what new visitors' conversion rate is. And in this case, it's like 4 and some change. This is not atypical at all. This is fairly common. What you're gonna see is that people coming to the site first, it's that typical like awareness phase, then it becomes consideration, and then all the way through the purchase funnel or the decision process. So that's why remarketing is key. That's why, you know, marketing through multiple channels is key. That's why getting people to opt into your email list, sign up on social, all of these things to like hit them further and further down the decision cycle. And of course, just like give them value. That's what it's really all about. So if you can get these new visitors who converted a really low rate to then sign up for email and get on your social and follow you on a different couple platforms, then you start showing them retargeting ads and bringing them back to the site, you're going to see a successful returning visitor conversion rate. That's just how it is. That's how we buy. And of course, the higher the priced item, the more decision like and thought process and people go into making a decision. If you're buying a flight, an international flight for a family of 5, it's going to take you a long time. You're first conversion rate is going to be shittier than this. Your returning visitor conversion rate is going to be way, way worse than this. So think about that. Like the higher price decision, the lower your conversion rate is going to be, the more likely people will book on returning as opposed to their first visit. If you have any questions, let me know. I'll go over how to layer this in on other reports in the future. I think that this is a good overview to get you thinking about how to use new versus returning user types. Really expect you to dig in and let me know if you find anything interesting in your data.